down his sweet head. The stars in the sky look down where he lay. The little Lord Jesus asleep on the I ask thee to stay close by me forever and love me, I pray. Bless all the dear children. Lay down his sweet head. The stars in the sky look down where he lay. The little Lord Jesus asleep on the I ask thee to stay close by me forever and love me, I pray. Bless all the dear children.
Good evening, everybody. What day is it? Well, I'll tell you, this is the best gift ever, other than obviously the biggest gift ever, the best gift. But it is so great to see everyone and anybody at home. We thank you for joining us online. We're so glad that we can do it whatever way is best for each person. So just real quick, a question for you. Knock, knock. Anna. And a partridge in a pear tree. Oh, the sec. No, no, okay. Okay. How about this one? Knock, knock. Harold. Harold. The angel sings. You know him. He comes, hark, the Harold angel sings. No, no. All right, I'll save the best for last. Don't applause, but knock, knock. Mary. Merry Christmas. All right, everybody, enough of the silliness, because we are here to worship the Lord. And we're so glad that everyone is here, and we're again glad that you were able to join us at home. So let's not waste any time. Let's call ourselves to worship our Father in heaven. Marianne, would you help us with our call to worship?
Good evening. Please join me and our call to worship. We gather in the darkness of evening to celebrate the newborn light. With Mary, we will ponder these things in our hearts. Lift up your hearts in thanksgiving, for a child, the child, has been born. His name will be blessed among all the earth. Come, our wait is finished. Let us worship the newborn King.
Lighting a candle is a simple yet profound act. It is a testimony to the power of light over darkness, something we will experience later during the candle lighting. 4 weeks ago, we began our journey towards Christmas and lit the first candle of Advent, the candle of hope.
Three weeks ago, we lit the second candle of Advent, the peace candle. Let us remember our need for a Savior to save us from our sins and give us peace with God.
2 weeks ago, we lit the candle of joy, Luke 2:8-11, and there were shepherds living out in the fields nearby, keeping watch over their flock at night. An angel of the Lord appeared to them, and the glory of the Lord shone around them, and they were terrified. But the angel said to them, "Do not be afraid. I bring you good news that will cause great joy for all the people. Today, in the town of David, a Savior has been born to you. He is the Messiah, the Lord."
Last Sunday, we lit the candle love, the candle of love. John 3:16-17, for God so loved the world that he gave his one and only Son, that whoever believes in him shall not perish, but have eternal life. For God did not send his Son into the world to condemn the world, but to save the world through him.
Jesus Christ is the true reason for hope, peace, joy, and love in this season and forever. As we light the Christ candle, celebrating the end of Advent and the arrival of Christ in Christmas, let us remember how our Savior came once as a lowly baby, that the world through him might be saved, and how he will return one day in glory.
Let us pray. Heavenly Father, we thank you for sending your Son, Jesus Christ, to be our Savior. We thank you that through him, we can have peace with you. We thank you for the hope, joy, and love we receive because of Jesus. Help us to embrace the gift of all Jesus Christ and to share this gift with others. We ask this in our Savior's name. Amen.
Let us join together in singing, O Come All Ye Faithful, number 234. Let us pray. Lord Jesus, we thank you that you brought light into the world and continue to bring light into our lives when we turn to you. Some have experienced darkness this year, but if we truly look, we know that you have been our light in those dark times. Let us experience your presence through your Spirit as a reminder that we have reason to celebrate and sing with joy for this season of celebration. Let our hearts be light as we participate in worshiping you and being reminded that you go with us even when we leave this place. And may the light that we feel this night, may we go and show it to the world around us. We ask this in the name of Jesus Christ, our Lord and Savior. Amen.
Hi, Pete Miller here. Good to see y'all. Most people would tell you I'm a pretty good guy, I think most people would tell you. Love my kids, love my wife, volunteer in the community, you know, all that good stuff. And hey, I've got the Christmas spirit. I tell you, I even believe in Santa Claus, huh? How about that, right? Yeah, I'm no Grinch, I'm no Scrooge. But this whole Jesus thing, I don't know, I can't get there. You're telling me God Almighty would become one of us? That's just crazy. That doesn't make sense, God becoming a man or a person. Come on. Well, anyway, it's getting tough to just keep pretending this, and I feel like a hypocrite, and I knew it would break my wife's heart. But this Christmas Eve, I said, "Hun, I'm not coming. I just can't do it. It's just going to frustrate me, and I'm just going to be angry. It's just going to ruin our Christmas, honey." I tell you what, honey, I got a great idea. You take the kids. Kids, you listen to your mama. You go to church. You listen to everything's going on. You sing the songs and all that. And I'm going to stay home, hon. I'm going to do all those dishes. I'll finish wrapping the gifts. And we'll have a good Christmas, all right? And when you come back, I'll have everything ready for you. Sound like goodbye? All right, now keep going. Keep going. See. I tell you, man, that plan's working great. Oh, man, got my chair here. House is all quiet, all alone. I'll get to the dishes, but let's just relax a little bit, because, you know, Christmas Eve and all that, dishes ain't going nowhere. Sometimes it's just good to relax. So a long winter nap, as they say. You know, once you put your feet down, oh. Gosh, it's snowing out there. It's really coming down pretty fast. What's that noise? If it's those kids, those neighbors, if they're throwing snowballs at my windows again. Whoa. It's not kids. There's birds hitting my window. They're trying to get out of the snow. Oh, no. Man, it's cold out there, too. Well, I'll tell you what I'll do. I'm the guy with all the ideas, right? I'm going to open my barn, and the birds can go in there and get away from the cold, all right? Birds, it's warm in here. You don't have to hit my window. You come in the barn and get out of the snow.
They're not coming in. What's wrong with birds? They'd rather hit the window? Oh, I know. They were seeing the light in my house. Maybe if I turn the light on in the barn, they'll come into the barn. Whoa! Okay, now they got light. Hey, birds, you can see. Come on in. Get in the barn. They're stupid birds. They're just freezing out here. Come on, birds, you got snow on. Food, birds like breadcrumbs, right? I'm gonna get some breadcrumbs, put them in the barn, the birds will come in. Oh man, birds, you're killing me. It's my nap time. Some bread, make some crumbs. Put some out here, lead them into the barn. Okay, that should do it, right? Stupid birds are just sitting there in the cold. What's wrong with them? There's food in there, it's warm in there, there's a light in there. I don't want to do it, but I'm going to shoo them in. Come on, birds, get in there. Get in there, birds. Oh, we're just scattering all over them. Come on, birds. It's for their own good. But I'm going to grab them and get them in there. Oh, jeez. It's harder than you think to catch birds. Don't they know? It's snowing, it's cold. If those birds don't get in there, I think they're going to die. Come on, birds, it ain't funny anymore. I'm trying, birds, work with me. I want to help you. The birds, I think they're just scared of me. I guess I'm so big and they're so small. And I look so different, they don't trust me. Maybe if I could just become like a bird and speak to them and lead them in to where it's safe, maybe I could talk to the birds. Maybe I could tell them, trust me and don't be afraid. And maybe if I was a bird, I could lead them into safety. If I became a bird, then I could tell them in their own language how to get to safety. God, I believe, God. Hark the herald angels sing.
Bad love. Are the heavens just
I think that was the short version. That's all right. It's all good, because we know Harold the Angel. And you guys sound really good. Would you like to play a game? All right. I'm going to say a song lyric, and you tell me what song it is. We're going to start out easy. All right. Laughing all the way. All right. You are good. Good, good. All right. Gets a little harder. The stars in the sky look down where he lay. Oh, very good. You guys know your Christmas. All right, the last one. The weary world rejoices. Man, there's no stopping you all. All right, yes. Oh, holy night. A thrill of hope. And as we said, some versions have this, the weary soul rejoices, or don't matter, the weary world rejoices. Can anybody relate to the weary world rejoicing? Are y'all a little weary? I know I am. Oh my gosh. When's it all gonna end? Come on, Shana. How about a gift of good news? Could they use some good news? Well, we got some good news for you tonight, because the weary world rejoices. It's almost like those two words shouldn't be together. If you're weary, why are you rejoicing? Well, it said the hope of the world is there. Well, let me ask, you know, we got some college kids here. Are you weary? Yeah. Whose idea was it to have finals and research papers and got to get back home? I remember when I was in college, is all I wanted to do was watch The Grinch Who Stole Christmas. And there wasn't no time for that. So, man, for my college people out there, my heart goes out to you. It ain't right. Hey, you know who it ain't right for either? My retail workers. Alice, where you at? Or Betty? Yeah, pray for our retail workers. They got to put up with us. You know? I mean, come on. I'm sure we're all just a delight to deal with. And they got to hear the same song over and over. Now, I mean, it's a rotation. I don't mean it's the same song, but I mean, you know, the one, I'd go bonkers after I heard, you know, Grandma got run over by the reindeer for the 20th time. All due respect to Grandma, no offense taken. I think it's a false news. It didn't really happen. So relax. How about our teachers? That's what I meant with the Alice and others. How many teachers we got here? Do you feel weary? What the heck? Are we going through this again? Alice told me they sent the kids home with their computers just in case. Yeah, all right. So, and how about, you know, we got our students. You know, that's no picnic either. Or parents. Well, how are you all doing it? Are you weary? I mean, when we signed up for this, the deal was we send the kids to school. We get 8 hours of, that ain't happening always. And we love you kids, don't get wrong, but sometimes distance makes fondness, they say. But anyway, and again, you know, we're joking and having a lot of fun, but how about for our police and firemen? Oh my gosh, they're out there doing the hard job. It never ends. Even as we get close to Christmas, a joyful time, you all know there's still things, bad things happening out there, and they don't get a break for the holiday. I mean, if the alarms go up tomorrow, it don't matter. It's Christmas. They're getting up and they're going out. So they're taking care of. So let's keep praying for all those people. Boy, oh boy, yeah, we're weary. And obviously we're weary because of COVID. Because of mutations. And, you know, we all been through this drill, so it's not a surprise. We thought last summer we were doing good, and then Delta, and then we thought we were getting better from that, and then, and what's the last letter of the Greek alphabet that I got the hope for? But because this is just, man, insane. But anyway, so you get it. We're weary. But here's the good news. Here's the news of Christmas. The weary world rejoices because Emmanuel, because of Christmas, God is with us. We don't have to do this all by ourselves. You weren't expected to do all this by yourself. God said, why are you carrying that burden all by yourself? He wants to come and give it, take it from you so that we can have Emmanuel, God with us, lighten the load. Interestingly, because I know some of you are saying, okay, Pastor Ed, I've heard that Emmanuel, God with us, many times. Matter of fact, I can count as many Christmases as I've been here, and I've heard it each time. And Emmanuel, God is with us, but life is still weary. What's up with that, Pastor Ed? Well, let's look at the Christmas story. We got Mary, we got Joseph, right? Did Mary's life get easier when all this happened? Emmanuel, God with her, God with us. Didn't get easier for Mary, or maybe Joseph. You know, it's always easier for the dads, right, Steve? Okay. Just, you know, yeah, it's not easier. So, if I may be so bold, and don't throw a hymnal at me or nothing, but maybe following God's plan for their life created some problems for them. I'm sure Joseph had some dreams. I'm sure Mary thought, this is going to be our life. And it was totally not that. But here's the key. Stuff is always going to be happening in life. And you have a choice. You can do it by yourself. And some of you haven't chosen that. And I hope it works out well for you, but I have not chosen that. Because I know when I do stuff myself, eventually it doesn't turn out well. I do my best, I work hard, and I try hard, but it almost seems like life's against you. And maybe you would embrace Emmanuel, God with us, because God wants to be with us through it all, through all the stuff that life is throwing at us. So why would God allow it all then? Why have God, he didn't come to keep us away from it. Jesus said, there will be troubles in your life. But he said, be of good cheer. I've overcome the problems. So Jesus is speaking the truth in John 16. He's telling us there will be problems. But he's overcome the problems. He's overcome the world. And he's proved it all through history. When Moses and the Hebrews came up to the Red Sea, God could have done a lot of things. He could have zapped the Egyptians right then with a big lightning bolt or a windstorm or a sandstorm. But interestingly, God opened the seas. He was with them through their problems. You see, when God comes with us, Emmanuel, and he gets us through our problems, then our faith increases. Then we know we can trust God, and we learn that how great God is and what God can do in our life. Another one, there was Daniel, and he was in the furnace. You know, and God could have spared him that, but God allowed him to be in the furnace, but God was with him and saw him through the furnace. Okay. Lastly, Jesus was with the disciples in the storm in the boat. Now, he could have just done he did it before. He did and the storm stopped. But this time, he's with them in the storm, and he didn't stop it yet. And they were all worried because Jesus wanted them to trust in him, that he would see them through the storm. But they freaked out. They failed the test. Now, I know you aren't going to fail the test. I know looking out here amongst many people, they could give testimony right now saying, oh, yeah, Pastor Ed, that's my life story. God has seen me through all the stuff of my life. And we could go on and on and on with all the people, many people, who would tell you, want to say, hey, I know you're going through some hard stuff, but hang on to God. He's going to get you through the stuff. He's Emmanuel. He's God with us. Now let's go to Peter. He was a fisherman. And Peter gave us some advice that he learned from Jesus. Peter said in 1 Peter chapter 5, verse 7. Now, Peter's a fisherman, right? What's a fisherman do? They cast. Now he's casting nets. I got any fishermen here today? How good are you at casting? Casting makes all the difference, right? And if you're casting, you're sending it out there. Peter says, you know what you need to do? You need to cast all your anxiety on Jesus. You know why? Because he cares for you. Because he cares for you. And that's what God wants to do. He wants to be there for you and get you through it. He doesn't want you to carry it. And a lot of you all are carrying way too much stuff. So may I introduce you to the greatest gift exchange ever. You all doing gift exchanges somewhere at home or at work? And you give something, and you put a lot of thought into it, and then somebody gives you socks. Well, we're going to re-gift that one, aren't we? All right, so you have your gift exchange stories, but this is the gift exchange that Peter's saying to do. He's saying God wants to take your anxiety, and he wants to give you peace. And you're saying, well, that sounds like a good deal. I'm going to finish up why Jesus is the greatest gift of all. The reason Jesus is the greatest gift of all, he's not just stopping your anxiety, but he wants your depression. He wants your anger. He wants your frustration. He wants your cancer. He wants all that you're dealing with, your relationship problems, your financial problems, all that you're dealing with, all the things that we fell short of, my lies, my greed, all that stuff where I've missed the mark. Jesus says, give it to me. And I will give you my righteousness. We're going to do a little gift exchange. Jesus says, I want to give you my righteousness. So then when judgment day comes, if you accept his righteousness, you accept him as your Lord and Savior. You say, I know Jesus was the Son of God. I know that he died on the third, and on the third day he rose again. He died for the things that I fell short of. He died for my sins. And then on judgment day, when you're being judged, you will not be seen for all the things that you have done. And that's not a pretty picture. But instead, we will be seen for what Jesus did, dying on the cross for you and for me. And that is the greatest gift ever. And I hope you take up Jesus on that gift, because that's, you wouldn't want to leave that gift unopened, would you? We got a big gift over here. I wonder what's in it, right? How do you find out? You got to open it. Yeah. And sometimes things don't come in big packages. Sometimes they come in little packages. Hey, ladies, any of you like little packages? Yeah. You don't need the big one, right? You're fine with the little packages, right? Well, maybe Jesus came in a little package. And it'd be a shame if that box sat up there forever and never got opened. Make sure you open the gift that God has for you. Jesus Christ. He wants to be your Lord and Savior. He wants to be Emmanuel with you. He wants to take all of your stuff. He cares for you. He wants to carry you through that. And I know that you received the greatest gift of all. And he gave us the greatest gift of all. And it's up to you whether you're going to accept it. But in giving that, we also have the chance to be like God and to give a gift back. You know, what will your gift be? We give gifts in many ways. And we're going to ask Mary Ann to come on up and help us with our offering and our gift giving.
Ushers, please come forward. Let us pray. Lord, we thank you for the gifts that you have given to us, the ways that you have provided for us, the ways that you have revealed yourself to us. And so now, Lord, we give back to you. We give you this offering, but we also offer up our lives to you. Bless them all, Lord, so that they can be used for the ministry that you've called each one of us and this church to do. We ask all of this in Jesus' name. Amen. You may be seated. And then what?
You do this and I'll do the lighting then.
Okay. I'm going to read to you from Luke 2, verses 1 through 7. In those days, Caesar Augustus issued a decree that a census should be taken of the entire Roman world. This was the first census that took place while Quirinius was governor of Syria, and everyone went to their own town to register. So Joseph also went up from the town of Nazareth in Galilee to Judea, to Bethlehem, the town of David, because he belonged to the house and line of David. He went there to register with Mary, who was pledged to be married to him and was expecting a child. While they were there, the time came for the baby to be born, and she gave birth to her firstborn, a son. She wrapped him in cloths and placed him in a manger because there was no guest room available for them.
Thank you, Marianne. Come to our special time. As you've seen, it gets pretty dark early. Some of y'all get up and it's dark, and you come home when it's dark. Unfortunately, you don't even get to see the light of day if you're inside, and that's a sad thing. But the good news is we have an answer for this darkness. And actually, you don't notice it right now, but actually it's getting about a minute brighter every day. You see, the light is overcoming the darkness. The Bible says, and scientifically it's proven, but we don't need that, but we know the darkness does not overcome the light. If it's dark, you light, and it shines a light. And these are dark times. We joke, we kid, because we have the joy of the Lord. The joy of the Lord is our strength. And God is Emmanuel with us. And we're going to get through it all. But also we know these are dark times. And we know if they're dark times, there's one thing that you and I and all we can do. We can light a light and we can spread the light. We can be peace. We can be loving. We can share the light of the world to all. Jesus said, I am the light of the world. And then he later said, you are the light of the world. So let us tonight, let us light a light from the Christ candle. And let us all be a part of that Christ candle, the light burning in us. Let's not hide it. Don't put a bushel. This little light of mine, what am I going to do? I'm going to let it shine. So now as we sing Silent Night, Holy Night, let us have a holy moment as we reflect upon the light of the world, the light that came into the world. But unfortunately, it says the darkness, people preferred the darkness. And I've seen that on the news. But let us be children of the light. Let us shine a light in this darkness as we sing Silent Night. Christ the Savior is born. God is with us. The light of the world has come into the world. Let us be children of the light. Let us keep this light burning for all year and into the future. We ask this all in Jesus' name. Amen. And wonders of his love. Thank you, Joanne, for giving us some heavenly music on our wonderful organ. And it sounded great. You all sounded great. I'm telling you, this is an awesome Christmas. And it's an awesome Christmas because of you. We are weary, but we're rejoicing. We're rejoicing because Emmanuel is with us. And we have God in our hearts. And we're going to go out into the world because that was God's plan. And we're going to do what God asked us to do. So now let us leave this place and wish you all a Merry Christmas and a Happy New Year. May it be a healthy one. Let's keep praying for each other. Let's keep connecting to one another. Let's reach out to anyone that we haven't seen in a while. It's so good to see you all. But let's keep this up. Let's keep the spirit of Christmas, the joy and the excitement going. Thank you for coming. Merry Christmas.
Merry Christmas.